Collectors of works by the famous Dutch artist Rembrandt have sometimes been surprised to discover that their Rembrandt isn't really a Rembrandt. Would you be able to tell? Well, now you have the opportunity to see Rembrandt's official works side by side with paintings done by his students in his workshops. They're all part of the exhibit Rembrandt in America, currently on display at the Cleveland Museum of Art. John Seidel is the co-curator of this exhibit, Rembrandt in America, and he's here to point out the differences between the two. So this sounds like a very interesting exhibit. Now, with regard to Rembrandt, I know a lot of artists aren't successful during their lifetime, but he was. So what made him so successful?
Well, he started out incredibly successful. Over time, he actually had all kinds of interesting and complicated things happen. He went bankrupt, he had to sell his house and art collection, and he ended up actually working for his common-law wife and his son in a corporation that was that they had set up in order in some ways to actually hide some of his finances. So okay. He had all kinds of interesting and complicated things happen.
Okay. But then he ended up being a portrait painter, right?
He did a lot of portraits, and certainly during his lifetime that's what most people probably knew him as.
Okay, here's one of those portraits now. So who is that?
So that's a guy named Martin Lowton. He's an incredibly wealthy Mennonite grain merchant. And what Rembrandt does, it's so remarkable, what people thought was so amazing about his work. He could just create this three-dimensional form that almost seemed to be living and breathing right in front of you.
I can see that.
Yeah, I mean, and you know, he seems almost, we've interrupted him. He's like holding a letter, turning as if we've just sort of interrupted him.
Wow. And I know Rembrandt did have students. He passed along all these techniques to students in his workshops. Were his students so good that they could fool the public that they painted it, but they thought it was actually his?
Well, Rembrandt didn't necessarily make it easy, because he often collaborated with his students on a work of art, because the guild regulations at the time, basically the union regulations, meant that he was going to be signing the pictures that came out of the studio whether he painted it or not. It was really more of an endorsement of a product.
Okay. And I think we have two pictures here, one by a student, one by Rembrandt. So how can you tell the difference? Which is the real one?
Well, Rembrandt was absolutely incredible at creating these three-dimensional forms in space. And so the picture on the left, which is from a private collection in New York, really captures that sense of a living, breathing figure right in front of you. Whereas the other painting, which is from Allentown, same model, so it's actually exactly the same person. But here you see with the light basically shining right in her face. It's very flat. You don't get a sense that she's in a real room. And when you see the paintings face to face, it's a little bit hard to see on the television screen, but the painting from Allentown is much more evenly and smoothly painted, and Rembrandt was famous for varying his brush strokes.
Okay, that was very interesting. So, and then you have an area in this exhibit that actually shows how the museum determines whether or not it's actually by the artist.
Yeah, we're looking at one of our portraits. Cleveland has four paintings associated with Rembrandt, although none of them are securely attributed to him. And one of the pictures we're really looking at in terms of how a scientist or how a conservator, someone who restores paintings, examines the picture and really determines authenticity, or starts to think about authenticity. Things you can't really see from looking at the surface with x-rays and infrared light, for example.
Okay. Now, I understand in the exhibit there's 30 paintings or so that you think are Rembrandt's,
right,
and 15 to 20 that are probably associated but maybe by his students.
Mm-hmm.
He's also got etchings and prints, so why are those important?
Well, Rembrandt in some ways was actually much more innovative as a printmaker. He was doing things that really nobody else had done before. Character studies, landscapes, working in all kinds of different genres, and also printed in a whole new way. So works like the ones we've been looking at, he tones the paper, for example. He uses different kinds of paper to get different coloristic effects. He innovated techniques.
Okay. Well, sounds like a great exhibit. So this stunning exhibit, Rembrandt in America, is at the Cleveland Museum of Art through May 28th. But don't paint yourself into a corner by waiting to experience it. Pencil in a date to see it soon. Then draw your own conclusions about which paintings are the real Rembrandts and which are not. My thanks to John Seidel for a masterful preview of this artistic master.
Thank you.
Thanks.
Learn more by calling the Cleveland Museum of Art toll-free at 1-877-262-4748 or click to their website, www.clevelandart.org. Next, climbing out of the depths of depression.